What's going on, guys? It's Unchained here, and I just got The Evil Within in the mail. It's a survival horror game on the Xbox One, PS4, and it's also cross-gen from Shinji Mikami, the director behind the classic Resident Evil games. Now, so far it's done really well on Metacritic. It's got in the mid-80s, and it comes with a really cool limited edition cover. It's got that, like, that high-pitched screech sound when you go to scratch at it. It's really cool. So, that's pretty nice, because I actually didn't pre-order any sort of limited edition. I thought I just got the regular. So let's go ahead and do the usual here, get a look at the back of the box. Looks like a Resident Evil game, and that's what I want to see, because, hell, if it's anything like RE4, it's going to be sweet. I personally wasn't a hater of Resident Evil 5. I didn't like 6 too much. I felt like there were too many gameplay elements that were in place there. And it makes perfect sense, because there were a number of different developers that were working on that game at the same time. And it shows, because they had a bunch of different elements going on, like quick time events and shooting segments and third-person shooting, survival horror. There were certain campaigns on it that I enjoyed, particularly the survival horror ones, the ones that make Resident Evil, Resident Evil. Now, this one, it has the classic upgrade system that Resident Evil's always had. Apparently, you sit in an electric chair and they kind of jolt in certain upgrades into your skull. It's pretty sweet. Now, I don't think this game is going to be scary like Outlast or as tense as Alien Isolation, which I gotta say is a really good game. I think this is going to be more of a atmospheric shooter where you have to watch your bullets and you have to decide if you want to use a match to burn a body and kill it for good, or use that last round to take someone out, and then as opposed to running away. So it really depends on what you want to do. Now, this one comes with one of those inserts, again, with the QR code, so I'll get that out of the way. I'll use that code in a second. But, here's the disc. I gotta say, it's one of the more detailed discs I've seen the last few months. It looks really cool. Then it comes with this little season pass thing here. Not sure what a season pass would accomplish for a game like Evil Within. I mean, what are you going to put out, new single-player content? Let's see, 3 new add-ons at one great price. Play 2 story-driven add-ons as Julie Kidman, Sebastian's mysterious partner. Encounter unthinkable enemies in new areas that reveal hidden motives and a harrowing evil. And a third add-on puts you in control of the Keeper, a.k.a. Boxman, also known as Pyramid Head, from people that can clearly understand the resemblance from Silent Hill, in a fun collection of mission-based maps. Maybe I'll get the season pass. Who the hell knows? I'm not sure if this is the kind of game that would have decent add-on content. But holy shit! This game has a manual! This is the first time I've seen a manual in a video game in probably maybe 5 years at the very least. Look at this! You could actually look at it and check out the controls and the pictures. You can read about the characters. This is sick. Honestly, I'm going to go ahead and say buy this game just for the damn manual. This is sweet. And oh man, got the controls in case you forget what shoots. That's really cool, actually. This brings back memories. I miss manuals. Now, I wonder if they decided to opt out for the digital manual for this one, and they went for the full-on booklet, which I'm really happy they did this. This is sweet. But yeah, like I said, this got reviewed really well. If you're thinking of picking it up, it seems like it's going to be a good game. I'm going to play it myself, and I'll be the judge, and stay tuned to my channel. We're going to be doing some videos, and I'm going to give you my opinions on if I think it's worth a purchase or not. So, stay tuned, and have a great day.